Hello again from my front porch. Actually, I'm out in Windsor Heights right now. I am out by the Walmart here in Windsor Heights off of, what is it, 73rd, right? Whatever that street is out here. If you're in Des Moines and you know where the Windsor Heights Walmart is, you know where I'm at. Anyway, I'm actually here in the parking lot in the...
Kaboomers.
Half price Kaboomers, where fireworks. They sell fireworks, see, back there. And I'm here with Arleen Sheppard. Who runs this little establishment? Say hello, everybody.
Hi, guys.
Now Arleen is not only is she we're going to talk about her fireworks here, because you know, like, there's that Katy Perry song, "Baby, You're a Firework." See, that's totally her. In all the positive and maybe some of the not so positive ways.
Because
she's Italian and Irish.
And redneck.
So we're going to talk about this stuff back here, but she also was running the business too, and she has to check people out. So we're going to pause every now and again so she can do that, like the people who are waiting right now. So go, and we'll see you in a minute.
You just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just
and she's back. Look, hello. Ta-da.
So quick.
So, it was like you were hardly gone at all, you know, at least for video purposes.
Exactly.
First of all, let's talk about this. So the name of the place is Kaboomers Half Price.
Yes, Half Price Kaboomers. Yeah.
Half Price Kaboomers.
But I am on Facebook, Half Price Kaboomers Windsor Heights.
There you go. So I'll make sure that's on the screen here too. Half Price Kaboomers. The next weekend is 4th of July.
Correct.
And so you're open for another week.
Correct. 10 to 10.
Ideally, she won't be open after July 4th, because that would mean everything that's back here and out in the big semi that's out in the parking lot, that's all gone.
I hope it's all gone. Come in, please, because I don't want to load it.
Yeah, but if it's not all gone, then you'll be here on the 5th.
I will.
Yeah.
Yes.
But the half price thing, it doesn't mean that she's like, okay, it's half price now because we're a week away. It's just always half price.
I have the best prices. Yeah. All my customers, they're shopping with me this is my fourth year, and they find me. I've been moved 3 times, and they have found me all through. This is my fourth year, like I said. They find me.
You can't get away. People just find you.
They love it. They love my tent. They love my prices.
Well, and we were talking before we started filming, you said that people have gone to other fireworks places.
Correct.
And then they come to you and they comment about how more affordable your stuff here is.
All the time. Yep. Every day, multiple people say, I've been to 5 tents. That's usually the limit they tell me most of the time. I've been to 5 tents, and your prices by far beat all of theirs.
Well, it doesn't matter how many others they've been to. Once they've been to this one, they don't have to go in any others.
No. Best fireworks, best prices, best service.
Yep.
Most fun.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Yes. So now with the fireworks you have here, have you been seeing an uptick in business this year? The reason I'm asking is, with all of the official fireworks things canceled, are you seeing a lot of people coming in and trying to maybe do their own 4th of July?
I do get a lot of that. I am selling a lot of the bigger things earlier, the big kids. Mm-hmm. But what I'm seeing, which is really kind of cool, and I'm kind of happy about that, is since the kids have been out of school for so long, the parents have been bringing their kids in and letting them shop. And this is their first year, and they're actually doing the fireworks and being safe with the fireworks and teaching their kids about fireworks safety and doing them at home. Mm-hmm. So that's really exciting.
So you hear parents talking. Do you talk with them about safety stuff too?
Yes, we talk about it, and they're all excited, but they're parents, and I'm a parent, and it is important to be safe. And
there's another customer. She's got to go take care of him.
Maybe not.
Maybe not yet.
No,
he's still looking. Yeah, keep looking. Buy lots. But yeah, so we were also talking about some of the stuff that's back in the shop back here, and you've got the little things, the sparklers, and the snakes, and the small little stuff you buy. But then you've got back over here, especially in this section, you got big massive things that what you call them, artillery,
cakes.
Right?
Oh, we've got best selection of artillery. Those are the single shot loaders with the tube. And then the cakes. I've got the best cakes where those are multi shots.
This is not ice cream cakes we're talking
about. No, but they're fun. You might have ice cream while you watch them, though.
Yeah, and some of the names are interesting names. There was a gunfighter one. There's a Walking Dead one.
Which,
insane. Which, you know, it, yeah, and the Walking Dead one I thought is kind of funny because if you don't follow the safety precautions,
it's true. I mean, things can happen, and things do happen when people aren't smart.
Yep. But fortunately, nobody in the shops here. Everybody's shops here is smart. That's why they're shopping here.
Yeah, and if they're not, I do give them tips.
Now, speaking of which, with people buying fireworks here in Iowa, because you said you used to live in Missouri, and the rules are a little different in Missouri about fireworks than they are here in Iowa. So what would you say to people that are asking, now, wait a minute, why would I go buy fireworks? Can I even use them here in Iowa? What would you say to somebody?
Well, it depends on where you live, okay? So I live on the south side, and there are a lot of regulations and rules. There are days and times, and you can go to city mm-hmm. of Des Moines, and you can look up fireworks 2020 rules and regulations. That should tell you something. Mm-hmm. You can also call like your local police department or, mm-hmm. And they will give you information on that. Those are set times. On the south side, I can't say they don't enforce the rules, but there's more leniency with the rules in certain areas. And I'm talking with my hands here.
There. Is that better?
Oh, no, man.
Wait, then we'll give a shout out to Sons of Gladys Kravitz.
Yeah.
I told her I should have checked to see what she was wearing because
they're playing tonight too at Down Under. I think I'm coming.
Oh, they're playing tonight?
I might be there, guys.
Well, because I was like, if I'd have known she was wearing Sons of Gladys Kravitz, I would have worn my Abby Normal.
Yes,
you know, we could have both represented.
It was a last minute clean shirt thing.
Well, yeah, I imagine it's a little warm in this tent, so I imagine you go through some shirts here.
Oh, God.
We don't need to talk about your hygiene habits. So.
You don't want to know.
but back to about the regulation stuff. Really, it's by community. Every community sets their standards.
Where I'm at, and some people in West Des Moines, they've been hearing them. So as long as, like I said, you're being smart, don't do anything past like 10:30 mm-hmm. p.m. Okay, mm-hmm. That's like 11.
Well, that's just considerate. And that's showing respect for people.
I do want to mention too, I do understand completely about your pets. Mm-hmm. I understand about PTSD. I have mm-hmm. family members.
Yep.
It's very dear to my heart. I love fireworks. At this time of year, I just would encourage any people that have pets. Mm-hmm. At this time of year, I don't think they should stop people that enjoy this. Mm-hmm. They do know at this time of year, just let everybody celebrate. And especially after the year we've had.
Uh-huh.
Please just keep your pets inside at this time. Keep them, you know, comfortable. And if you have PTSD, which I have people coming in buying fireworks that are from the mm-hmm. military. Mm-hmm. I give them a box of Zap Snap. So if you're in the military, come in, you get a box of Snap.
you get a freebie.
But no, I do appreciate you guys, and I understand what you go through. So I really just encourage you to be receptive to everybody else mm-hmm. that enjoys it, and put yourself in a safe position where you feel comfortable.
Yeah. Well, and I know that where I live, I don't actually live in an actual official city area. I live between the Des Moines and Ankeny, so I live in the Sailorville Township, and I'm sure there are rules and regulations for Polk County that apply there, but I know I hear them shooting off all the time around me, and so they're not really enforced. And frankly, I don't have a big concern about it, unless it's, you know, in the wee morning hours, you know.
And they're being stupid.
Yeah, you know, but that's usually because someone's being, you know, drunk and partying, and that's not a good combination either. Drinking too much and shooting fireworks, that's not a good recipe.
I have been on Facebook sharing my crimes committed.
Oh, and look, it's starting now. It keeps coming in. Has business been really good this year?
It's been good. I kind of, it'll peak up the last 4 days. If you want something, mm-hmm. come in now. I'm telling mm-hmm. you, because
the selection will be much better right now.
You're gonna have a line at my door. I mean,
not only will there be a line, but stuff will be picked over.
Oh yes,
because right now there's some primo stuff here.
Correct.
And again, the pricing is all really great. So. Correct. So you want to come in and take a look at it now.
Seriously.
And I should have grabbed it and brought it over, but there's this sword thing that she has. What's it called?
You want to go grab it?
Yeah, sure. We need to just come over here.
Oh, I have two swords.
Oh, that's okay. Because so she's got this. This is what I call the sparkler on steroids, because you ignite the end of this thing, and then what happens?
It's like a fountain. So it'll shoot out like 10 to 15, 20 feet.
So it'll shoot out 10 to 20.
We don't want to shoot anybody.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah. Don't point it at anybody. But a couple of I was gonna say a couple of kids could swerve. No, that's probably a bad idea too. They put on eye, but
I've seen it.
But it's not advised.
No, I just show you what not to do.
Yeah. So looks like you're starting to pick up with some business here, and so we'll wrap this up. But I wanted to say, good luck with that you really need it, because you're always successful every year. But this is fantastic, and the prices are awesome. The stuff here is really great, and if again with everybody canceling the cities and stuff canceling their 4th of July fireworks things, this is a great chance for you to look at doing something for your family or for a little gathering, and and she'll set you up really well. And
in fact,
if you come in and you start buying some stuff and you're like, well, I'm getting this and this, she knows everything that's here, and she can then recommend, well, what would make this just that much better is if you add this in too. She can help manage your whole personal little fireworks display. So
I am good at that.
Yeah. So the expert right here. Not only is it good prices, but look at the brain. Mm-hmm. Yep. Plus she likes Sons of Gladys Kravitz. So right there.
Yes.
Right there. See? So double brain. All right. So thank you, Arleen. Appreciate it very much. It's always great seeing you.
It is. And I'm so happy to see you.
All right. So I'll let you. It looks like you may have some folks that want to check out again. So with that, I'll let y'all go, and I'll see you next time from my front porch.